is what everybody is doing now. Let me also join the bandwagon and do it also.
My name is Busola, and on this channel, I make videos about business, tech, and lifestyle, just like this one. So if you're new, do consider subscribing and liking this video. The first tip is do what you would like to do. Inasmuch as a business is supposed to solve a problem or meet a demand, you should do what you would like to do. And if the idea of your business is not geared towards what you like, what you are interested in, what you find fulfilling, it's going to be rough. There's no way to sugarcoat it. It's going to be rough. For example, where I live, we import a lot of rice into the nation. So there is actually a demand now for localized rice farmers. But guess what? I don't want to be a rice farmer. I don't want to plant rice. I don't want to go into the... I have no interest in being a rice farmer at all. Even though there is a demand for it, I do not find it interesting. I do not find it fulfilling. And it's just not something I want to do. Like, if you are in a business or there's a family business or something of the sort where there's a pre-existing business and you have no other option but to follow in that line, that is totally different. So consider that. Next tip is don't start your business based on a trend or a fad. For example, we didn't have it here in Nigeria, but there was a time rainbow grilled cheese sandwiches were a thing, and you know, they cut the cheese open and it stretches. And there was a time all over Instagram, all over the internet, everywhere. It was everywhere. But right now, I think that fad has died down. So it's something that you would want to consider, because trends come and go. They are here today, they are gone tomorrow. You do not want to build a long-lasting business based on a trend or a fad, because people's tastes, people's opinions are changing ever so often. And if the trend is here, you make the money you want to make, but what happens, you know, a little bit of time down the line and it's no longer a trend? What's going to happen to your business? So you want to build your business around lasting solutions, providing solutions. Fine, you can innovate, you can introduce new things to your business as time goes on, but it shouldn't be because,
oh, this is what everybody is doing now, let me also join the bandwagon and do it also.
The third tip is be ready to work hard and work even smarter. There's this misnomer that once you start a business, you get to go on expensive holidays, you know, maybe to Mallorca or Maldives or Santorini or wherever you find interesting, south of France, and have oodles and oodles of abundant cash that you just throw around, and you get to go to parties and buy the latest cars and your hair blowing in the wind. And no, the fourth tip is be ready to put in the time. Whatever it is you're starting, be ready to put in the time. I'm not saying be a robot, don't have time for any other thing. You have to put a little bit of balance in there, but be ready to put in the time. If you're working a job, you know that, okay, let's say a 9-to-5 or an 10-to-2 or something. You know that you have a dedicated time that you go to your job, and at the end of the day, you get paid a certain amount. Starting a business is not like that. Sometimes your hours are just skewed all over the place, but be ready to put in the time. And like I said earlier, time, work hard, but work even smarter. It is very, very important. The fifth thing is for you to consider the costs. And when I say costs, I'm not talking in terms of currency whatever currency that you have in your country. I'm not talking just in terms of money. I'm talking in terms of the things that you would need to start the business. Yes, there are businesses that you can start with just your phone, and you can check that video by clicking the card right up there. There are businesses that you can start with your phone and nothing so much. But if you're considering a business that requires more than just your phone and an internet connection, have you considered what it's going to cost you? Have you considered the time, the permits, the registrations, the business registrations, probably even the business name, taxes that are attached to it? Have you considered the types of apps that you're going to use? What's that I'm talking about? You have to consider this thing and look at everything holistically. What do you require? Do you require a co-founder that will have something to contribute? Not necessarily cash, but maybe another skill that you would need, so that you're not paying salaries upfront, but you can co-found with somebody. So that these are all the things that you need to really, really hunker down and think about before you start. My name is Busola, and on this channel I make videos about tech, business and lifestyle. If you're new, do consider to... My name is Busola, and my name is Busola.